This is part two of graphing parabolas, and on this video, we graph the following three parabolas. This is part two of parabolas, and at the end of parabolas part one, we noted that a function of the form f of x equals x squared plus c is a parabola opening upward with vertex 0c, which also happens to be the y-intercept. And then we have something to add on to this. The axis of symmetry is the y-axis. Which has the equation x equals 0. And by the way, if you know what the vertex is, the axis of symmetry of a parabola that's a function will be a vertical line, and all vertical lines are x equals some number. It'll be whatever the x coordinate of the vertex is. So that's why it will be x equals 0. Okay, we're going to look at a similar type of function that's also a parabola. So let's say we're going to graph the function f of x equals negative x squared. Remember, you could also think of that as y equals negative x squared. And we had already filled in the chart before for y equals x squared. Remember, we just squared each of these numbers. And those were the order pairs we put in for the graph of y equals x squared, but we want y equals negative x squared, so it's going to be the opposite of all these numbers, negative 9, negative 4, negative 1, 0, negative 1, negative 4, and negative 9. So the order pairs we want to graph on here are negative 3, negative 9, negative 2, negative 4. So get out a piece of graph paper and put the video on pause and graph those seven ordered pairs. All right, this is what you should get. Here's negative 3, negative 9, negative 2, negative 4, negative 1, negative 1, 0, 0, 1, negative 1, 2, negative 4, and 3, negative 9. And this time we have a parabola going down. In fact, it's a mirror image of the parabola y equals x squared, which was going up. Remember, if we were going to do y equals x squared, or f of x equals x squared, that one opened upward. And it was the basic look of this parabola, except going upward. So the difference here is that, notice when you have x squared, that can't be negative, and then you're putting a minus sign in front of it, so all the y values are going to be below the x-axis, because all the y values are going to be negative. So that's what the graph of f of x equals negative x squared is. By the way, another way to do it is turn your paper upside down, graph y equals x squared, and then turn it back, right side up again, and you've got it. So that's another way to graph f of x equals negative x squared. All right, now, how about if we wanted to graph, let's get rid of this one. How about graphing in green f of x equals negative x squared plus 7? What do you think that might look like? Well, all the y values will be whatever negative x squared is, but plus 7 more. So all I have to do is add 7 to all of these y values, negative x squared plus 7. If I add 7 to each of those numbers, we get negative 2, negative 3, negative 6. Is that right? No. Oops. I take that back. We're adding 7, so that'll be positive 3. Positive 6. 7. 6. 3. And negative 2. All right. An easier way to do is imagine just taking each of these ordered pairs that you see on the graph of y equals negative x squared and going up 7. So that goes up 7 spaces, this goes up 7 spaces, that goes up 7 spaces, etc. Or I think of this as the origin, right up here. I pretend that's the origin. I go over 1 and down 1, over 2 and down 4. So there are lots of ways of thinking about that. Over 3 and, see, we're going to have down at negative 2, downing. And we're going to get this, sorry, kind of up a little bit more, that graph. We have arrows on the end because this parabola also goes down. It's kind of average looking again. But the vertex of this parabola is at 0, 7. So the vertex here is 0, 7, where the vertex for this parabola is 0, 0. And hopefully you're noticing when something gets added here to the negative x squared, the vertex is going to still be 0, c. But this minus sign means the whole parabola is going to go down. The axis of symmetry is still the y-axis for these. That's going to happen when there's no like x term. Notice we have an x squared term. We've got a constant, but there's not like a plus 5x. There's no x term. So let's see if we could summarize this. So a function of the form f of x equals negative x squared plus c is a parabola opening downward. So when you have a minus in front of the x squared, it's going to go down. When it was positive in front of the x squared, it went up. So it's a parabola opening downward. Still has the vertex 0, c, which is also the y-intercept. And the axis of symmetry is the y-axis, which is the equation x equals 0. That's a vertical line. So let's have you try one. All right, here's one for you to try. Graph f of x equals negative x squared plus 4, accurately as possible on some graph paper. State whether the parabola opens up or down. State the vertex, that's an order pair, and state the equation of the axis of symmetry. So put the video on pause and try it on your own first. You can either do this by plugging in some ordered pairs or using another method. Okay, here's how I do it. The minus sign tells me it goes down. Since there's no x term, the vertex is the same as the y-intercept. It's just 0, 4. So I know it's going down, and I have a vertex here at 0, 4. And that means the axis symmetry is this y-axis. So this is the vertex, and I'm going to put the axis of symmetry, AOS. It's x equals 0. It's always of the form x equals some number. And then since it's going down, instead of going over 1 and up 1, I'm going over 1 and down 1, over 2 and down 4. I remember those basic ordered pairs, 1 squared, 2 squared, 3 squared. See? Over 3, down 9, because that's 3 squared. Or you could just go on 1 half and automatically go to the other side and pick the other ones. And so there we go. That's a pretty accurate graph of f of x equals negative x squared plus 4. The last thing you want to note is that often you're asked to label the axis of symmetry, and so we usually do a little dotted line to show where the axis of symmetry is. So in this case, it's just the y-axis, so we put a dotted line here, and that's the axis of symmetry, x equals 0. So if you're asked to label the axis of symmetry, you use a dotted line for the axis of symmetry. If you're asked to label the vertex, right here at the vertex, you can put V for vertex, 0, 4. So now you should be able to graph parabolas going up and down that have either just x squared plus c or negative x squared plus c. And of course, this could be you're adding a positive number, or you could be adding a negative number. It could also be negative x squared minus 4, for instance. That works as well. So those are the ones that we've done on parts 1 and 2.